insulator here. Okay. So we have special case for this type of insulator.
Wall. So your new much superior compared to the commonly prescribed draft. If it is within this one, the FTR region, then you will say that.
So, okay, in this video, we will be talking about elementary function in which we are going to get the Laplace transform. So we have here the function itself. So we need to get the Laplace transform of sine kt. So k is a constant. So we need to get the Laplace transform of sine kt. Okay. So we will be using the definition of a Laplace transform in order to get this one. So this is really getting the Laplace transform. So that is we are now deriving the Laplace transform of sine kt. Okay, so let's go directly to the solution. Okay, so we have Laplace, okay, of sine kt. Okay, so by the definition, so we have the integral of e negative st, and our f of t here is sine kt times sine kt dt with limits from infinity to zero. Okay. Now, we will consider this one. Okay. So maybe we just get this another color here. I guess it's not clear. So we just have the white. Consider. We just integrate this one as an indefinite integral. So integral of e to the negative st sine kt dt. So we have two transcendental functions, so we'll be using integration by parts. So we have by integration by parts. Okay, so our u is sine kt, so the derivative of that one, that will be our du, so that will be k cosine kt. So our dv is e to the negative st dt. So integrate both sides. So we'll end up with v, which is equal to negative 1 over s e to the negative st dt. Okay. So that is our v. So we just have this one as uv and I. UV. So you just use the formula for integration by parts. So we have u times b. So our integral e to the negative st sine kt dt. So we have uv. So that will be negative 1 s e to the negative st. This will be our v times u, which is sine kt, minus integral of v du. So our v is negative 1 over s a to the negative st, and our du is k cosine kt. Okay, then we just simplify this further. So we will have negative 1 over s a negative st sine kt plus, so positive. We just factor out this one. So 1 over s e negative st of, maybe we will include the k because k is also constant. So a negative st cosine kt. So we need to consider this integral again. So this is still by parts. Maybe we just have a new space for that one. So consider consider integral of e negative st cosine kt dt. Okay, so we have this one. So our u, so we'll have the trigonometric function cosine kt. So du, so that is negative k, negative because the derivative of cosine is negative sine, so sine kt. Okay, so the k here is coming from the derivative of our angle. Our angle is kt, so that k is constant, so the derivative of a constant times a variable is the constant itself. Okay, so you just review your knowledge in differential calculus. Then we have dv. So dv is e negative st dt, integrate both sides. So v is equal to negative 1 over s a negative st. Okay, now let's just continue this one. So using the formula for integration by parts, we have integral of negative st cosine kt dt is equal to u times v. So our u is this one, cosine kt times v, which is negative 1 over s e negative st, then v du. So we have minus integral of v du. So our v is negative 1 over s a negative st, then our du is negative k sine kt. So dt, you could put the dt here. Okay, so we round out of space. Then you just simplify. You have negative 1 over s a negative st cosine kt. So we have here negative, negative, so positive, another negative, so that will be negative. So we have negative, that will be k over s e to the negative st sine kt dt integral. Okay, then we'll just factor out here the k over s. I believe this is k over s. Okay, k over s. So we have negative 1 over s a negative st cosine kt minus k over s integral of a negative st sine kt dt. Okay, so let's combine this integral, the solution from the integral, this one here, and we just simplify so that we could get the integral of e to the negative st sine kt. Okay, so maybe we should have another slide. Okay, so let's just have this one. So the integral of a negative st sine kt dt, so from this we have negative 1 over s e to the negative st sine kt. Okay, so we have negative 1 over s a to the negative st sine kt. This will be plus the integral. Okay, this will be k over s. So we have k over s. Okay, so this is k over s. Then the integral here is e to the negative st. Let's just check. E negative st cosine kt. Okay. E negative st cosine kt dt. Okay, of course we have solved this one, this part here. Okay, from here, this one, so we just substitute that one, so we'll end up with negative 1 over s a negative st sine kt plus k over s. Then we have negative 1 over s e to the negative st cosine kt. So this is negative 1 over s e to the negative st cosine kt. Then we have minus or plus? Minus k over s. Okay, we will just continue in this part. Minus k over s integral of the integral of this one e negative st sine kt. Okay, e negative st sine kt dt. Okay, so let's simplify this one further. Of course, our solution is much longer now, but we'll just continue, just apply our knowledge in algebra in simplifying terms. So we have this one is this is minus, so plus and minus, we just distribute the key s on these terms. Okay, so we have negative k over s squared a negative st cosine kt. Then this one also we just distribute, so this is also negative. So we have negative k squared over s squared, so we have 2k over ss. So we have e negative st sine kt. Okay, so let's not forget the dt here. Okay, so this one, if you notice, this is this part of the term on the left side of the equation, this one here. Just underline that one. Okay. This one here is similar to the term on the right side or to the integral itself. So what we'll do is to transfer this term here, which is equal to this term, to this side of the equation. So we'll end up with, we will have a new slide. Okay, so we'll end up with integral of e negative st sine kt dt plus k squared s squared integral of a negative st sine kt dt equal, it will be equal to negative 1 over s, negative 1 over s, so the remaining term on the left side of the equation, negative 1 over s e negative st sine kt, this will be negative, I believe, so that is negative, okay, negative k s squared e negative st cosine k, okay, cosine kt. Okay, so we just simplify this one into a single term. So we will have 1 plus k squared over s squared integral of e negative st sine kt dt is equal to, so we'll factor 1 over s, so negative 1 over s, then that will be 1 over s and e negative st, so e negative st. Okay, then we'll have here sine kt minus k over s cosine, wait, this is plus because we have factor out, no, cosine kt. Okay, so we could simplify this further solving for the integral. So we have e negative st sine kt is equal to negative 1 over s a negative st sine kt plus k over s cosine kt all over, okay, 1 plus k squared over s squared. Okay, I believe we should put our equal sign over here. Okay, so maybe we could select this integral and move it below. Okay, so we have that one. So we just simplify this one further again. Okay, maybe we could copy this one so that we could not, we'll just not rewrite this on the next slide. Okay, paste. Let me just move over here. Okay, so we just simplify the denominator here. So we will end up with negative 1 over s. Should move it little upward so that will not be short of space. So negative 1 over s a negative st sine kt plus k over s cosine kt all over s squared plus k squared over s squared. So as you notice, I just get the common denominator, this common multiple, or just get the LCD, less common denominator for this term here, these two terms here. So we could cancel out our s, this one. So we're left with s on the upper part. So we'll have s a negative st sine kt plus k over s cosine kt, okay, all over s squared plus k squared. Okay, so now we will apply here the equation. So we just resolve this one now as a definite integral. Okay, so maybe we could copy this one, or maybe just rewrite on the new slide. Okay, new slide. Okay, so we have the integral of a negative st sine kt is dt. I hope I just put dt here, so we would have dt, okay, because we could not integrate without the derivative, no? Okay, so we have negative s e negative st, okay, so this is found in the previous slide here. Okay, this will be sine kt plus k over s cosine kt all over s squared plus k squared. So if we are now make this one as a definite integral, so we will retain our limits, so that is from 0 to infinity. So this will be evaluated from 0 to infinity. Okay, so the previous video we have established that e raised to the power of negative infinity because we'll be substituting this one first to the value of s as the value of t as an infinity. Okay, so we could say that e raised to the power of negative infinity is equal to 0. So this part here, this first part of our evaluating this integral will just be all equal to 0. Then minus this one, in which we are going to substitute the value of t as 0. So that will be minus, because that is upper limit minus lower in limit. So that is going back to your discussion of definite integral and integral calculus. So we have here negative s, okay, s, so that will be s e negative 0, of course that will just be, we should have this one as substituted, so s 0 because our t is 0, sine our k times 0, so okay, plus k over s cosine k times 0. Okay, so maybe we could have put another bracket here, all over s squared plus k squared. Okay, so I believe the negative is, this one is negative, okay, so this will be positive, so we end up with positive because negative and negative. So sine 0, so k times 0, that will just be 0. Sine 0 is equal to 0. So this a raised to the power of negative s times 0, so that is a raised to the power of 0, this is equal to 1. And k, cosine k of 0 or 0, that will be equal to 1. So this term here is eliminated. So we'll end up with 1 times k over s, because this is 1. Okay, so our answer will be negative s for this one times k over s. Okay, of course this will be all negative, okay, all over s squared plus k squared. Then we could not cancel the unit, so we'll just cancel this one, okay, the s. So that is positive now, negative and negative. So we'll end up with k all over s squared plus k squared. And this is now the Laplace of sine kt. Okay, so that is, of course, there is a condition for this one, provided that our s and our k is greater than, okay, so it's not equal to 0. Okay, so if they are equal to 0, then this will be indeterminate. Okay, indeterminate. Let's just check if we have I got the condition for this formula. Okay, so I just look here on the, okay, so the proper way for that is that s is greater than 0. Okay, s is greater than 0, so that is the condition. Okay, so now we have here the Laplace transform of sine kt. So let's just write this one carefully. Sine kt, which is equal to k over s squared plus k squared. So if we have here the, for example, we just have here a new slide. Okay, new slide. For example, we have the Laplace transform of sine 2t. Okay. So of course our k is equal to 2, so we have k, that is k over s squared plus k squared. So we have s squared plus k squared, which is 2 squared, and this now will be equal to 2 over s squared plus 4. So that is how you will use the formula. Of course, you could have this one using the definition of a Laplace transform, and you will go to all of this integration and simplification, and you will arrive with the same answer. So again, thank you for watching this video, and as always, enjoy learning.